Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss how do acids and bases react with each other. You read this in class 7 also. We do this activity 2.6 for this study. Take 2 ml of dilute sodium hydroxide solution in a test tube. Add a few drops of phenolphthalein. As you already read, that phenolphthalein give pink color to sodium hydroxide solution. So whole solution become pink in color. What is the color of solution? Pink. Add few drops of HCl drop by drop. So slowly color disappear. Is there any color change? Yes, color change and color start to disappear. And after some time it's totally disappear. Why did the color of phenolphthalein change after the addition of an acid? Aisa kyun hota hai? Acid react with base and neutralize it and form salt and water, sodium chloride and water. This is the reason color disappear, because phenolphthalein give no color in neutral solution or in acidic solution. Now we add few drops of sodium hydroxide solution, color reappear, now solution become basic. So if in your mixture base become excess, phenolphthalein give color. If HCl become in excess, phenolphthalein gives no color. Why do you think this has happened? It happened due to the neutralization between sodium hydroxide and HCl. So out of these two, one which become excess, phenolphthalein accordingly behaves. Next one. In this activity, we have observed that effect of base is nullified by the acid and vice versa. So what is the general reaction? Acid react with base and form salt and water. So what is the actual reaction is? Sodium hydroxide aqueous solution react with HCl aqueous solution. As I already told you, HCl is a gas. So we use its solution known as a hydrochloric acid. So NaOH plus HCl changes into NaCl plus water. The reaction between an acid and base forming salt and water. Salt and water both are neutral. So this reaction is also known as neutralization reaction. In general, neutralization reaction can be written as base plus acid changes into salt plus water. Now, reaction of metal oxides with acids. For this, we do activity 2.7. We take copper oxide. Copper oxide is black in color. We add dilute hydrochloric acid to it and slowly mix by stirring. You will note the color of the solution start to change and it become bluish green color. It is formed due to the formation of copper chloride. Copper chloride, copper second chloride. So the general equation is metal oxide. General equation is metal oxide plus acid changes into salt plus water. And above reaction can be written as a chemical equation, copper oxide. This is black in color. You add HCl with constant stirring. It forms CuCl2 plus H2O. Balance the reaction, 2Cl. So it should be 2H, H2O, O balance. This is copper second chloride. And its color is bluish green. Bluish green in color. So this is the chemical equation. So one more important point here. This is reaction is just like acid-base reaction. This is acid react with base and gives salt plus water, right? These two reactions are same. So we can say this copper oxide is basic in nature. In general, we will say metallic oxides are basic in nature. We repeat the same activity. We will take calcium hydroxide. You already read this equation. React with carbon dioxide, you know it has OH, so it is a base. Another point, it gives blue color with the litmus solution, it means it is a base. React with CO2, form calcium carbonate plus water. You know very well, this calcium carbonate is salt and this is water. Again, this reaction similar to this acid-base reaction. CaOH2 is base, well-known base. CO2 correspond to acid, salt and water. That means CO2 is acidic oxide. In this way, we can prove that metal oxides are basic in nature and acidic oxide, non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. And our general reaction, metal oxides plus acid gives salt plus water. Now, now we write the balance equation. We written that, and we conclude that metal oxides are basic oxide. Reaction of non-metal oxide with base, I already told you. That is, non-metal oxide react with base, form salt and water. So it proves non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. Now come to the questions. Question number one, exercise. Why should curd and sore substances not be kept in brass and copper vessels? Listen very carefully. Your curd and sore substance are acidic in nature. Acidic in nature, it means they have the free H plus ions. These H ions react with the metallic surface and form the compounds. So they make the food poisonous and your food become bitter in taste. So this is the reason we should not cap our sore substances, curd, etc. in the metallic, reactive metallic utensils. Now second question, which gas is usually liberated when acid react with a metal? Hydrogen gas generally liberated when a metal react with acid. You read this equation, zinc react with HCl, it forms ZnCl2 plus hydrogen gas. This gas has physical properties: colorless, odorless, and release as a tiny bubbles. Now chemical test for this one. We expose this gas with burning splinter. It burned with pop sound. Jaise bottle ka dhakkan kholte hain, cold drink ki bottle ka dhakkan, waisi wali sound hoti hai. That is the pop sound. And reaction, it react with water. Jab bhi hum kisi cheez ko air mein burn karenge, it react with oxygen and form H2O plus energy release. So balance the reaction, twice H2 changes into twice, react with O2 forming twice H2O. This is the chemical equation. So in this way we identify the liberating gas, that is physical properties: colorless, odorless gas, released with tiny bubbles, and chemical. One experiment is there. When you expose this with the burning splinter, it burned with pop sound, and during this reaction, this particular burning, it react with oxygen and form hydrogen plus O2 form 2H2O plus energy. So this is the equation. Now question number 3. Metal compound A reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid to produce effervescences. The gas evolved extinguishes a burning candle. It means it is not supporting the burning. Write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction if one of the compound formed is calcium chloride. For such type of reaction, first you write the equation, that is A plus B changes into CaCl2 plus a gas release C. Now important point note to here, this gas extinguishes the fire, so it may be CO2 gas. This is the gas, it may be CO2 gas. Another important point, salt is forming here. A plus B react and form calcium chloride plus C. So this A should be kya hona chahiye? Metal carbonate. As you know, metal carbonate react with acid, form salt plus CO2 plus water. So this is A is metal carbonate, CaCO3. React with HCl as given in your question. It forms CaCl2 plus a gas CO2 that can extinguish the fire plus H2O. Balance the equation. 2Cl, so it should be 2. H2, CO2. 1O release, react with this one, and Ca. Now reaction is balanced. So the CaCO3 is a metal compound that react with the HCl, form CaCl2 plus CO2 plus H2O. Listen one time again. These are the very important questions. First you write the equation as it given. That is, metal compound A react with dilute hydrochloric acid, produce effervescences, and you know very well CO2 has the physical properties: colorless, odorless gas, release with fizz sound and effervescences. This gas can extinguish the fire. That is correct. CO2 is used as a fire extinguisher also, so it can extinguish the fire. Write a balanced chemical equation and by telling the name of the compound A. right? So we do that too. First we write A plus in place of B, you can write HCl as given in the question. CaCl2 is also given in the question, plus C. And the C gas, you know, can extinguish the fire. So on the basis of these clues, we know very well this is a reaction in which carbonate react with HCl form compound salt plus carbon dioxide gas plus water. So accordingly we write the reaction BHCl. A should be a carbonate or bicarbonate. CaCl2 given, CO2 as per the clue, and H2O. This CO2 can be identified as physical properties: colorless gas, odorless gas, released with fizz sound. जैसे कोल्ड ड्रिंक की बॉटल खोलते हैं तब जो सनसनाहट की आवाज आती है, दैट इज द फिस साउंड. एंड हाउ कैन बी केमिकली चेंज विद द हेल्प ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट व्हेन वी पास दिस गैस थ्रू कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड सॉल्यूशन. यू रेड दिस इक्वेशन आल्सो इन द चैप्टर 1. इट फॉर्म कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट प्लस वाटर. दिस इज इनसॉल्युबल, सो इट गिव मिल्की अपीयरेंस टू द सॉल्यूशन. व्हेन यू फर्दर पास CO2 gas through this mixture, CaCO3 plus water, it form calcium bicarbonate. It is water soluble, so milky color disappear here. It's a test to prove the CO2. So CO2 can extinguish a fire, and CO2 also can be tested with this equation. This A should be CaSCO3 also. It may be this one, that is carbonate and metal carbonate give the same reactions. Plus 2HCl gives 2HCl, so CaCl2 gives, these are the two, SCO3 react with this one, so twice H2O plus twice CO2, this is the reaction. So A जो है वो calcium carbonate भी हो सकता है, और it may be calcium bicarbonate also. In both cases you get CaCl2, H2O, CO2 in the same case also. As you know very well, metal carbonate and bicarbonate react with the acid gives salt, carbon dioxide and water. Thank you.